Welcome to MOOC lecture on Strategy and Introduction to Game Theory. In this module, we are going to talk about something called Iterated Elimination of Dominated Strategies. Before we get into this, let us take a moment just to think what we have done so far. What we have done? We have learned something called dominant strategy equilibrium, strictly dominant as well as weakly dominant strategy equilibrium. We have also done NAS equilibrium. Now we are going to look at another solution concept that we get using iterated elimination of dominated strategies. For that, we need to define what do we mean by dominated strategy. The simple definition is UI, that is the payoff to player I, given that he takes action AI and all other players are taking action A minus I. For example, when we have two players, player one is taking action AI and another player action is given by A minus I. When player I does worse than by playing AI in comparison to BI, no matter what all other players are doing, then we call that AI is strictly dominated by BI. Similarly, we can also define the notion of weakly dominated. When do we call action AI weakly dominated by BI? That no matter what other players are doing, player I can, by playing BI, player I does at least as well as by playing AI, but in some situation he does better by playing BI. Let us take an example. The example is from Prisoner's Dilemma that you have already seen. What you have seen there, that confessing is strictly dominant strategy. Why it is strictly dominant? That no matter what other player is doing, confessing is better than denying. Now, as we have done a strictly dominant strategy, we can also look at the strictly dominated strategies. As confess is strictly dominant, deny is strictly dominated. Why? Because no matter what other player is doing, deny is worse than confess. So we have to be careful about it. Now, game theory is all about that you put yourself in your other player's shoe and also understand that they are doing the same thing. The key is very, very simple in this, that a player would never, a rational player would never play a dominated strategy. For example, let us take this game. We have the same game twice that I have given. Let us look at player 1. Here we have player 1 and here we have player 2. 1 is the row player and 2 is the column player. If we look at the action, action R and action L of player 2, what happens? Let us look, let us compare. 10 is greater than 0, 20 is greater than 0, 20 is again greater than 0. So no matter what player 1 is doing, L strictly dominates R, or in other words, R is strictly dominated by L. So a rational player would never, earlier what did you say? Earlier in the strictly dominant strategy equilibrium, we talked about that this player will play L. Right now we are not interested in what would this player play. What we are interested in, what this player would not play. So what we know, that this player will not play R. So we can take R. Now, because we have assumed common knowledge, not only player 1 and 2 are rational, player 1 knows that player 2 is rational and player 2 knows that player 1 is rational. So player 1 knows that player 2 is rational, so player 1 knows that player 2 is never going to play R. A rational player will never play dominated strategies. Okay? So player 1 knows that player 2 is never going to play R. So we can take this whole thing out. Okay? Now player 1 is looking at a smaller game in which player 2 has only two strategies, L and C, left and center. Player 1 doesn't need to consider now this strategy R of player 2. So earlier player 1 didn't had any dominant strategy, or player 1 didn't had dominated strategy. Now, but let us look at in the reduced game, player 1 has a dominant strategy, and player 1 has also a dominated strategy. I mean, in fact, two dominated strategy. What do we see? That in reduced game, that M strictly dominates U as well as M strictly dominates D. So what we say, that now we can eliminate, let us say we are eliminating U. Why we are eliminating? Again, let us pay attention that in the whole game, player 2 is rational, so player 2 is not going to play R. But player 1 knows player 2 is rational. Why? Because we are assuming common knowledge. So player 1 knows that player 2 is never going to play R, so we are taking this part out. Now player 1 is rational, so we can say that because of presence of M, he will never play U. Now let us look into the next step of the common knowledge, that not only player 2 is rational, player 2 knows that player 1 is rational. So we can say that player 2 knows that player 1 will not play U in the reduced game. Now we have much smaller game, only involving two strategies from player 1 and two strategies from player 2. Now let us look at it. What do we see? That again M strictly dominates D. So we can remove D also. And continuing with the process, between now we have only one strategy for player 1 and two strategies for player 2, given that L strictly dominates C. So we can remove this. So this would be the outcome. Even if you had used the Nash equilibrium concept, this was the outcome you would have obtained. But this is another technique in which we can get equilibrium in some of the games, if not all games. And it is iterated elimination of strictly dominated strategies. Again, I have the same game. I just want to show you, in case of if when you are removing the strictly dominated strategy, you don't have to worry about order. So let us see, you remove this as we had done earlier. Now, first you remove this, and again, then you remove this, you remove this, and again the outcome would be same as M, L. And this is the equilibrium that we obtained, iterated elimination of dominated strategies. Now, if we are doing the iterated elimination of weakly dominated strategy, we have to be careful. We may end up removing one of the candidates for equilibrium because of the order. So let us see what happens here. What do we have here in this game? Do we have weakly dominated strategy? We have M weakly dominates T. M is at least as good as T, no matter what the other player is doing, and strictly better than in when player 2 is playing R. So M weakly dominates T. So we can remove T. Now what happens? That R, once we remove this, and let me repeat again, player 1 removes this T because player 1 is rational, and because of common knowledge, player 2 knows that player 1 is rational, so he doesn't need to consider that player 1 would ever play T. Now what happens? Look at player 2. For player 2, R weakly dominates T. R weakly dominates L. So this can be removed, and we have these two possibilities that I have in the next slide. In the next slide, you see that these are the two possibilities I have talked about. Also, if you pay attention, that M not only weakly dominates T, but M also weakly dominates B. So in this time, we are going to remove in this order. Let us first remove B. Okay. Then we see that R is weakly dominated by L. So we will remove R. And the possibility is here. So what I am saying, that when we are removing weakly dominated strategies, then we have to be careful, okay? But when we are removing the strictly dominated strategy, then the order doesn't matter, as long as we are removing only strictly dominated strategy. The same thing cannot be said about weakly dominated strategies. There is one more illustration that I want to give you. Let us look at this game. Is there any dominant strategy for any of the player? Let us look at it. For player 1, can T be the dominant strategy? No, because when player 2 plays L, T is better than M, but player 2 plays R, M is better than T. So, not the case. Again, when we compare TB or MB, we see there is no dominant strategy for player 1. And similarly, we can figure out there is no dominant strategy for player 2. So, in this game, here of course we have player 1. Whenever I don't say, I mean that the row player is player 1 and the column player is player 2. So, in this game, none of the players have any dominant strategy. Is there a strategy for any player dominated by any other strategy of the same player? Notice, earlier you might be thinking, why did we learn this technique? When if a player has strictly dominant strategy, the player would definitely have a strictly dominated strategy. But it's not true other way around, and that we will see. In this game, none of the players have strictly dominant strategy. But if we allow for the mixed strategy that you have learned by now, then we see that B is strictly dominated by half of T and half of M. Okay? Half of T and half of M. How can we say that? We can simply, let us take the mixed strategy for player 2. Let us say that player 2 is mixing L with probability Q and R with probability 1 minus Q. If this player plays, first player plays T, how much he earns? 3Q. 3 multiplied by Q, 0 multiplied by 1 minus Q. If he plays M, then how much is his payoff? 0 multiplied by Q, 3 multiplied by 1 minus Q. And if he plays B, no matter whether player 2 is playing L or R, his payoff is always 1, so 1. Now we can plot player 1's payoff with respect to Q. Let us say Q here is 0, Q here is 1, and Q cannot be greater than 1, so I can draw it like this. What do we have? Let us draw first payoff from T. So it's going to be here 3. And similarly, we will have, let us use a different color to indicate the payoff from M, it's going to be like this. And how much is payoff from B? Again, let us use green color, it's going to be like this. 1, this point is half, and this is again 3. What do we see? If we mix T and M half and half, what's happening? The payoff would always be equal to 1 by 3. That is clear from this. It is always equal to 3 by 2, while payoff from B is equal to 1. So, payoff from mix of T and M, equal mix of T and M, would always be higher than the payoff from B. So, we can say that half of T plus half of M strictly dominates B. So, what we can do? We can eliminate this. This thing would not be, this cannot be done when we are using the strictly dominant strategy equilibrium concept. But this can be used in the case of elimination of strictly or weakly dominated strategies. Then we can say, of course, now we see between R and L, then L strictly dominates L, so this also can be taken out. And what do we get? Again, player 1 will not play T because M gives strictly higher, so the outcome will be this much. So, in this case, what we get an outcome from iterative elimination of dominated strategies, but we cannot get any outcome using strictly dominant strategy. So this we have to be careful. Before we close, we should be careful about one more idea. Let us look at the best responses of player 1. So if player 2 plays L, then player 1 best response is to play T. 3 is higher than 0 and 1. So best response from player 1 is T. That's what I have written here. BR represents best response, 1 represents from player 1, and this represents the strategy of player 2. So best response from player 1 is T. Similarly, what we have best response from player 2 is when player 1 is best response from player 1 is M when player 2 is playing R. Let us see here 3, which is higher than 0 and 1. What do we get? B is never a best response. Now, as it turns out, I want to state it without proving that eliminating strictly dominated strategy is equivalent to eliminating never the best response. Okay, so this is very, very useful that we don't have to, let us go back, we don't have to draw this chart to see, figure out that do we have a strictly a strategy which strictly dominates any other strategy. We don't need to do that. We only need to figure out the best responses, and a strategy which is never a best response is strictly dominated. We can remove that strategy. So this is also a useful technique in figuring out the outcome. So now you have a large set in of solution concept, that one is a strictly dominant strategy equilibrium, then you have iterative elimination of strictly dominated or weakly dominated strategies, then you have NAS equilibrium. Notice that in a strictly dominant strategy equilibrium and strictly or the elimination of iterative elimination of dominated strategies, we are using only two assumptions. Those assumptions are rationality and common knowledge. But when we are using NAS equilibrium, we have to add one more assumption, that is that players have belief and their belief about other player actions are their all the players have correct belief about other players' action. Also, I would like to add one more thing, that when we are able to solve a game using a strictly dominant strategy equilibrium notion or iterative elimination of dominated strategy or weak dominant strategy equilibrium, then we say that game is dominance solvable. Otherwise, the game is not dominance solvable. That's it for this module. We will meet again and talk about some applications. Thank you.